This video is going to be an introduction to logarithms and their graphs. And I just want to start with a word of warning. A lot of people find logarithms very confusing. Now, the point to bear in mind is, if you can understand them, that's fine. But if you can't understand them, ultimately the most important thing is to be able to know how to use them and how to work with them in math problems. Okay? But let's start out and try to understand them. So what I've got here is an exponential equation, y equals 2 to the x. And let's say I want to find the inverse of this function. Okay, so when you look for an inverse, the first thing you can do is swap the x and y values. So that's what I'm going to do. Instead of y equals 2 to the x, I'm going to write x equals 2 to the y. Now, I can't leave it like that. I have to isolate the y. So I'll write y equals, and this is where the problem begins. So far in the math that we've learned, there's no way I can think of to complete this equation, y equals. If you want to pause the video and try to do it on your own, that's fine. Now, when mathematicians ran into this problem, what they did was invent logarithms. They invented a new function. And I'll show you how a logarithm works in this case. After the y equals, I'm going to write the word log for logarithm. And then after that, I'm going to take the 2, which was the base for the exponent y. And I'm going to write that as a small 2 after and a little lower down than the word log. And what I've got so far, I'm going to read as y equals the log base 2, because base was a 2, because 2 was a base originally. And then I'm going to take the x, and I'm going to put that after the log. So this is written as y equals the log base 2 of x. Now, probably the best way to go from here is to compare these two functions, the exponential function, the y equals 2 to the x, and its inverse, the logarithmic function, y equals log base 2 of x. So let's try that. Here I've written the functions again, and what I'm going to do is make a table of values for each of the functions. So let's start with the exponential function. Okay, so let's use the input values negative 1, 0, and 1. Okay, so when x equals negative 1, that means I'm raising 2 to the negative 1 power, and that means I'm going to have 1 over 2 to the first power, which is just 1 half. So when x is negative 1, y is going to equal 1 half. When x is 0, since any number to the 0 power is 0 is 1, when x is 0, y is going to be 1. And when x is 1, 2 to the first power is going to be 2. So when x is 1, y is 2. Okay? Now, I want to make a table of values for the logarithmic function. So since the logarithmic function is an inverse of the exponential function, all I have to do is use the numbers in my table of values for the exponential function, but swap the columns. So in my input column, my x column, I'm going to have 1 half and 1 and 2. And for the outputs, I'll have, let's see, when x is 1 half, y is negative 1. When x is 1, y is 0. And when x is 2, y is 1. Okay, so let's look at this logarithmic function and its table and see if we can understand what this means. What this is saying is that if I take this base, which is 2, and I raise it to some power, I'm going to get a 1/2, right? Because 1/2 is an x value. And what I'm going to find out is what that power is. So if I raise 2 to the 1/2 power, I'll get a negative 1. I'm sorry. I told you this was confusing. If I raise 2 to the negative 1 power, I'll get a 1/2. So 2 is going to produce a 1/2, which is my input, when I raise it to this output, the negative 1 value. Let's try another one. 2 raised to this output value, this 0, that's a y, is going to give me a 1. So if I wanted to know how I could raise 2 to some power to get a 1, I would do this logarithm and I would find out what I got, what I needed was a 0 power. If I wanted to find out how I had to raise 2 to some power to end up with a 2, I would use the logarithm and find out that the power I wanted was 1. Okay? If you need to, pause this, run it back, try it again. It may take a while before it really sinks in. Okay, I just want to take the rest of the video and quickly draw a graph of these two functions so we can see that we're really dealing with an inverse function. Okay, so I'll draw a quick graph. I've got my x and y axes. Okay, so starting with the exponential function, when x is negative 1, y is 1/2. So that would put me over here. When x is 0, y is 1. So that puts me right here on the vertical axis. And when x is 1, y is 2. So that would be here. And then exponential functions always form a nice curve. So I'll draw this curve. And now we'll go on to the logarithmic function, which should be the inverse of what I've just drawn. So let's see. When x is 1/2, y is negative 1. That's here. When x is 1, y is 0. That's on my horizontal axis. And when x is 2, y is 1. So that puts me here. And now let's see if I can draw a smooth curve. Okay, so there we have it. It's an inverse function. If I had a diagonal line, the kind you would get if you had y equals x, then I could see that one function is reflected across that line to form the other function. Now, from what you know about exponential functions, what you can do is reverse everything you've known and say that about logarithmic functions. In other words, since we know that the domain of an exponential function is from negative infinity to positive infinity, then the range of a logarithmic function is going to be from negative infinity up to positive infinity. Since exponential functions always have a range that goes from 0, but never touching 0, up to infinity, the domain of a logarithmic function is going to start just after the 0. It will never actually touch the 0, and it will go to infinity. Okay, so I hope this makes some sense. Again, the important thing is to know how to use these, and I'm going to follow this up with some more videos where we actually find out how to deal with logarithms, what to do with them. Okay, so take care. See you soon.